made possible by a National Endowment for the Arts Artworks Grant and the NMSU Departments of Art and Geological Sciences. We're so grateful to everyone involved for making all this possible. My name is Michelle Lanteri. I'm the new interim director of the University of Colorado, and we're very grateful for the large gallery space to present tonight's and this season's programs. We're invested in bringing world-class art to this area in Las Cruces. And in order to do that, we need to update our building. So as one of two hubs for contemporary art in Las Cruces, we're asking you to review Go On C, which is going to be on November's ballot. The bond's not going to raise taxes, and what it does is it makes it possible for our department to continue to be a local and regional art center into the future. Tonight, we're honored to feature a pair of presentations. The first one by Nancy McMillan, Geological Sciences Department Head and Professor, and the second one by artist Ryan Thompson, Department Chair and Associate Professor of Art and Design at Trinity Christian College in Palos Heights, Illinois. After both the talks, we'll have time for questions. And now I'd like to welcome Tiffany Santos, the co-curator of GEOMAGIC and the director of the Zuhl Museum.
She has a degree in geology and Russian, which I found out today, from NMSU. And she has a PhD in geology from Southern Methodist University. She's a geochemist, and she's taught mineralogy for 3 decades. Yeah, decades. So she's definitely qualified to give this talk on color, geology, and geochemistry. And I will turn it over to Nancy.
Thank you. Geology and art, that it would be worthwhile just giving a talk on color and how does color work. So that's what we're talking about. So here we go. Okay, so color is related to the electromagnetic spectrum. So here is, are you asleep yet? Okay, so here is the electromagnetic spectrum. It's a whole wide variety of waves that are passing through this very room, even as we speak, everywhere from gamma rays down there, over here to radar and TV and radio waves. And our eyes, human eyes, can only see a tiny slice. So we can just see this tiny, tiny little slice of that. The rest of that's going on, but the only part that we can sense with our eyes is just a tiny bit of light. And we see the lower wavelengths as purple and the higher wavelengths as red. Okay, so how do we get colors in minerals? Well, this is a model of an atom. Okay, so you remember this is a nucleus. That's where the protons and the neutrons hang out. And then these green things, which are way too big and out of scale, those are electrons. Okay, and electrons are spinning around in these orbitals. But let's take a closer look. So here's a closer look, and it turns out the orbitals are not just single vibrational areas, but actually some of them are double or even triple. And each one of these layers, if you will, has a different energy level. So what happens with color is this. Here comes a photon of white light. Okay, here's white light. It's going to hit an electron that's right there. And that white light causes that electron to pop up. It gives it energy and it pops up. Okay? And what happens is that energy that it takes to pop up absorbs some, but not all of the energy. And so some of it is absorbed, but some of it is reflected back. And the reflected light, then, is seen as a color, okay? In this case, green. So let's review, okay? We have an atom with different electron orbitals. White light comes in. It pops the electron up. And when it pops it up, it absorbs some of the wavelengths, but not all. And the color you see is what's not absorbed. Okay? So it is very much like cheerleading, right? So what I'd like to do now is a thought experiment. numerous times in the day, so you know what that fire should look like, right? Okay, so we're going to pretend that each of us is an atom in the red stripe of the American flag, okay? And we're going to see what happens. So, okay, if I might get me, I got excited. How about you? If I might get to you, what do you do? You're okay, and you, and you, and you, and you. Come on, everybody. Come on. If I might get to you. Okay. So everyone's electrons are excited, right? So what happens with the next photon that comes in? Oh, sir. Thank you. Chromium atom in a ruby, and here's one in an emerald and superficially they look the same, right? But can you see that these two orbitals are different than these? Okay, that's because the oxygens around the ruby are pulling on them, if you will. So what happens is the light comes into the chromium in the ruby, it excites the atom, and it gives off red light, absorbs everything but red. But when the light comes into the chromium atom in the emerald and gets excited, you can see that it's actually absorbing a different amount of light, and so the light that's given off is green. Okay, so if you don't like that explanation, here's a football one, okay, for all of you football fans out there. Okay, so crystal field theory is just like offensive lines in football. Exactly like it. Okay, so here is the eye formation, which from now on will be known as the ruby formation. Okay, so here's the line of scrimmage, and over here we have the defensive line, right? So that's the defensive guys, and they want to run across this line and nab our quarterback and take the ball, right? So here's our offensive line, and we're all lined up to protect ourselves from the defense players coming across the line. Okay, and in this eye formation, you can see that the defense could kind of get through that hole and they could get through this hole, right? So this organization of players is going to absorb some defensive players but let other defensive players through. Okay, here we are in the emerald shotgun formation. You can see it's a different formation. Now it's going to be hard to run through that hole because that wide receiver is there. And so in this organization, different defensive players are going to be absorbed and other ones are going to get through. So you should get different colors depending on the offensive line. Okay, I'm going to move on because that probably is all we're doing. So, these colors, this is what we have to celebrate in the Zuhl collection, all these incredible colors. So in petrified wood, the greens and blues are usually due to little bits of copper, cobalt, or chromium. Pink is usually due to manganese. Black is due to graphite, which is carbon. That's actually little bits of the wood that's left, but broken down to its fundamental element. Red, brown, and yellow is due to iron. And then the white and gray is the pure silica. So here are some close-ups of this beautiful piece of Arizona wood, where you can just see how the colors are distributed. So these streaks of red have different composition than the streaks of yellow. Again, here, the black, these are little tiny pieces of graphite that are distributed through here. Just beautiful layout.